Namaste. After my resignation from the corporate company and before starting my office, whether I started an office for HR or what did I do, there were a couple of major incidents which happened. Those major incidents which happened needs to be shared in order to pick up the right rhythm for the flow of the episodes which will follow after the resignation of the job from my corporate company. It was on 28th of April 1991, I met Mahavatar Babaji in the form of a sadhu at Canary Caves in Mumbai. In the last episodes, I have described the way in which I was drawn to Mahavatar Babaji and the way how I met Mahavatar Babaji. Subsequent to 1991, there were several changes which took place in my life. And I will, bits and pieces, I will pick up one by one later. And now I will pick up one very important incident which happened. The person who gave me book and which fell down, and when I opened, Babaji's photo hit me, which I have shared in the previous video. The person was an interesting character, extraordinarily intelligent. He had resigned the job from railways. Only his wife was working in railways in a manufacturing division near my house. He was introduced to me by another friend who had several of his problems, which I will take up later. But he introduced me to solve some of his problems. His wife and this friend's wife were colleagues known in their office. That is how they come to know. And he has brought this person and introduced to me. Now this person, although he is not a qualified in astrology, he had almost very good knowledge as astrological dictum. He used to delineate the horoscope very easily when I was not even knowing the alphabets of astrology. Now, he never met my father. He had just an introduction maybe. And he was not knowing about my father's ability in astrological chart, but by looking at the charts created by my father, he would have had some idea. Because my father has not drawn horoscope for anybody, so much horoscopes he has drawn for me. He used to, wherever he used to get a piece of paper, he will draw my horoscope and he will start doing his own permutation combination. You know, one of the horoscopes what he has written, which I possess even today, he had mentioned a yoga called Bala Yuddha Raja Yoga. Bala Yuddha Raja Yoga. This particular Raja Yoga, I have not come across anywhere, any books are described anywhere. I don't know where from my father got this Bala Yuddha Raja Yoga. The planetary combination is described by my father that Guru is exalted in Karkataka, Saturn is exalted in Tula, and both these planets are major planets. While Guru, the Brahaspati or the Jupiter, is a Lagna Lord for me, the Saturn is the second Lord in the 11th house, the third Lord in the 11th house. Both these planets are exalted, and all other planets, all the planets, are hemmed between Guru and Saturn. This position is described by my father as Bala Yuddha Raja Yoga. And probably because he had so much of knowledge on astrology, he had challenged the doctor who said, "Your son will die." He challenged the doctor that my son will not die, which happened. And my living today is a testimony that the knowledge what my father had. This apart, the person who had given me the book, he had a very extraordinary knowledge. In addition to that one, he was much against these rituals, the practices, the pujas, the orthodox way of Hindus. He wanted to cut across all these things. He was not interested. Although he had a deep knowledge on astrology, he used to go to temples, but he was a peculiar person to understand. This person had even an idea or notion of not having a child. Whether he had a notion of not having a child or not, he used to talk of celibacy, but he got married. Whether he wanted a child or not, but somewhere in deep into the subconscious, I could see the pain of not having a child, especially his wife. It is in 1996, I think, around mid of 1996, one day suddenly he brought one ground plan as well as the building plan of his house. Initially he did not tell me that it is his house. He gave the plans to me and he said he wanted to throw some light on this property. This is kept for sale. So when I touched this ground plan as well as the building plan, it gave a shock to me, because this building was standing just opposite a temple. That is what was the vision which I got. So when I met him the next day, I told him this building is obstructing a temple or a religious entity, and this is part of the temple. Maybe the records may show something like that, different to what I am stating, but it is a part of the temple. And I asked him whose property it is and what it is. He said it belongs to his mother, which is possessed by his father. His mother was no more. His mother got the property through her mother. Her mother has taken sannyasa and she has retired her life into some ashram. So as a result of the death of his mother, the property automatically came to be possessed by his father. Now the father is the custodian for a long time. Now his father wanted to sell off this property and give the partition to three of his children. They wanted to move out to a rented house, and he wanted to give the share of four pieces, wanted the property proceeds to be shared by three children, one part going to his father to take care of him in his old age. This was the plan. But when I touched the property document, I was revealed that the building is obstructing a temple. It belongs to, or it is part of the temple. And as a result, I told him, if you ask me any comments, I would say it is better don't take any part in this property. I don't want you to carry certain sins of holding the property of a temple. Tell your father to deal as he wishes. And as far as you are concerned, please don't have any share. He took the document to consult his father. Next 2 days he came running and took away all the papers, stating that his father told him to bring back the papers. And subsequently I also heard through another friend that his father has commented that Dr. Rajagopal will confuse you, so he is telling something which is not having any logic or anything. The property documents are there, so don't go to him. Bring back the papers. I had no issues over that one. I had given the paper and he has taken and gone away. This happened in around the mid of 1996. 1997, I could see the couple's pain of not having a child. And one day, I was thinking of the sadhu, who is none other than Babaji, and I closed my eyes. I was revealed that I should do a remedy for these couples to bear a child. And I was told I should take a remedy suggested by Adi Shankara and accordingly set a date for doing the remedy. The date I chose was 18th of November 1997. I think it was on a Tuesday. And in those days there were no mobiles or a telephone on the way. But there was a system called a paging message. So I paged him to call me. He called me over my landline. And I communicated to him that I am preparing a remedy for them to have a child. Because they were not having child since 80 years. And when his wife visited a very big hospital, the gynecology who attended to her stated that she cannot bear a child and her uterus is not capable of producing a child. So they dropped the idea. They were running here and there. They wanted to live their life without a child. So when I called him that I am preparing to do a remedy for him, he said he is on the way to a Subramanya temple near Durbulapur, in our maybe 40 kilometers from my residence, and he will meet me in the evening. But I communicated to him, the evening the remedies will not be ready. Please meet me on Thursday. That Thursday I handed over the remedy to them. It happened to be a Pushya Nakshatra, and Babaji's Pushya Nakshatra. Later only I came to know Babaji belongs to Pushya Nakshatra. After 2004-2005 only Babaji revealed me. But incidentally it happened to be a Pushya Nakshatra on Thursday. Tuesday the remedy was considered on 18th November 1997. It should be 20th of November 1997. So after the remedy was conceived, a male child was born. It was unexpected, it was astonishing. It was a miracle for the couple, couple's parents, especially his wife's mother and father, as well as the sister. From his side, he had only his father. His sister was somewhere in Bangalore and his brother was in US. A beautiful male child was born in a normal delivery on 20th of October 1998. Even the doctor who attended to her, the same doctor who earlier denounced a childbirth for this same, she was the same doctor who attended the childbirth of this lady, she was also astonished. Around November 1997, there was a very big news in Bangalore, in Malleshwaram area. The area is just walkable distance from my office in Malleshwaram, but at that time I was not having an office. In Malleshwaram there is a very old ancient temple called Kadu Malleshwara temple. In this temple Babaji revealed me that he had visited this particular temple, and behind the temple where it was a small hill was there, and where once Rishi Gautam was visiting there, and Babaji had visited this particular place to see Gautama Rishi. Behind this temple, children were playing, and Usually the children will gather in the morning or in the evening and they will play in that area. One day it happened, one building contractor came with the excavators and he wanted to remove all the garbages in and around the area where the children were playing, and he wanted to construct some private building. So off the way he left and gone for the day, a boy who was playing in a group, the ball went and fell down in a ditch, and he went and tried to put his hand. He saw his ball was totally drenched in water. The water was fresh and he washed the ball. Subsequently, he saw water was coming in a very good flow. He called the boys and all the boys started removing the dust here and there. They came and they saw a mouth of a granite nandi, and within a few hours or within 2 or 3 hours, lot of people gathered there and they could unearth a temple itself being hidden in that area. Water was coming from, continuously water was flowing from the nandi. Below the nandi there was a temple where a Shivalinga, Ishwara's Shivalinga, was installed, and the water straight away from the nandi's mouth was falling on the Shivalinga. When they started removing the entire mud filled there, they could find a temple itself, beautifully built temple, and nandi was so beautiful and water was coming. You can see this video as well as the photo, which you can see now. This is the nandi, this is the temple, this is the entrance of the temple, and when you go inside the temple, you take a right and go, take a left turn, get down and enter the temple. It looks like a cave temple. So the moment a temple was unearthed, hundreds and thousands of people gathered. They started worshipping, performing puja, and instantly a temple was ready to be worshipped. The news came in the evening newspaper, next day newspaper it had come, and I was also astonished, but I could not go. After a week or 15 days, I took my parents also, and we went there. We had a darshan of the nandi and we came back. This incident was over. It was around November 1997. Subsequently, after the birth of the male child on 20th of October 1998, one day the friend came to my house and he said his father wanted me to visit him immediately and meet him. He is waiting because his father was an elderly person. I don't want to reject the call. When I reached Malleshwaram, about to enter his house, I was astonished. I asked my friend, "Is it your house?" He said, "Yes, it is my house." I told, "This temple is here. When you brought a piece of paper to me, the plan, I told that your house is obstructing a temple. Did I not tell you like this?" He said, "Yes, you told me." "Then why you have called me?" "No, that regarding that subject only my father called me. He wants to discuss with you." Later, about 1 to 1.5 hours, I discussed with his father. He said that, "I am very sorry, sir. I was not knowing what message you communicated on that day. I got it confused. I mistook it. I suspected you. But today the temple is here. The fact is unfolded." Then I suggested to him, "This is the fact. I have been revealed, you are not supposed to take the property of this one." I came out. Subsequently, the property was sold or it was shared, I did not have any information, because this person also took a transfer to somewhere in railways. They were working in a manufacturing factory in a wheel and axle plant. In those days it was called wheel and axle plant. Today it is called rail wheel factory. So there, Bangalore, there was a division of railways. Earlier Bangalore was attached to Southern Railway. Subsequently it was made as a Southwestern Railway. So as a result of division in the Southwestern Railways and from Southern Railway, a new division was created in those days, and his wife opted for Dharwad, and they got a transfer and they went back. Subsequently, once or twice I met, and I will share how he got disconnected from me and where is he. I don't know as of date, but he got disconnected, and his son may be 20 years now. He is somewhere in Mysore area, I know that much, but no contact has been established. With the unearthing of a temple in Malleshwaram area where my friend's property existed, my confidence level in knowing something, in knowing some answers for some questions, enormously got boosted. So with this one, I had a wrong assumption or assumption that I could answer anything. With this one more incident I will have to share that will bring a culmination to this incident. Rectification happened through Babaji for all the answers to be flown through mind scope. The word mind scope itself was given by Babaji. So till 2005, when the word mind scope was coined, all the answers I got through touching the photograph, touching the paper, some major incidents were revealed properly. But wherever I was little overconfident, it happened to be a debacle. And later Babaji guided me how to do it, that I will share later. After the next incident, next video what I am going to share, after I narrate the incident, then only there will be clarity in what I am telling, where I was overconfident, where I made mistakes. That will be known only when the next week video is shared with all of you. For the time being, the fact remains, one remedy was the cause for birth of a child where the mother was ruled out for a child conception. A temple was identified at a place where the children were playing. Opposite to that one, there was a house which they wanted to dispose. They came to me even before the temple came into its existing place visibly. I was hinting, because that is what in my vision it had come. As a result, they did not believe it. They suspected. Subsequently, it proved to be so. So I will leave this episode here to say that much more is likely to come, especially with this incident, 2004 incident, I will merge with the next video. Then there will be more clarity, more suspense can be cleared. Thank you.